to really discover in the depths what's free of any tragedy, what's contained in the tragedy, and what's contained in the joy and bliss of your life, what is free of all of it. So it really begins with actually examining what it evokes when you are confronted with something as horrific as what happened in Aurora or Virginia Tech or Columbine, and the list goes on and on and on. There was the event that happened in Norway. So there seems to be this repeating pattern of tragedy. And we could go into the karmic reasons, the philosophical reasons, the psychological reasons, but none of that really addresses why we're here, which is to meet this living presence in your heart. So it really has to come back to the personal. So there's the impersonal of what's wrong with the culture, what's wrong with the society, but then we bring it into the personal. What is that feeling inside of you, Jonathan? What did it evoke? Right. Well, the mind is powerful, so the mind is going to move and flow and change and try to get your attention. So the difficulty is to actually stop following that movement and bringing the attention into the heart or into whatever is here in this moment. So if you get in touch with what that event made you feel, what do you feel about it, you personally? I've often said that Ramana was selfish. And the reason I say that Ramana is selfish is that when he discovered the truth of himself, when he discovered this reservoir of peace in his heart, he ran away from home. He stole money. When his parents came to try and get him back to come home, he refused. He wouldn't even eat. He wouldn't pay attention to people that were around him that were trying to help him, because his attention was so focused on the truth. So there's a selfishness in that. And so inquiry is actually pulling back from that movement of mind to get or to grasp or to hang on to discover what's always here, what's always alive, what's always fresh inside of us. It's the oasis of peace inside of you. But in order to discover this oasis, you first have to meet what it is that you might be avoiding. And I don't know what you might be avoiding, Jonathan, but there, our conversations tend to kind of drift out into this conversation about the society and about the culture. And there's nothing wrong with that, but I just want you to notice how your mind moves out to the culture, to the society, about money. But in that movement of mind out in that direction, there's an avoidance of something inside of you, and I don't know what it is. It's not like I know what it is. And this is the nature of inquiry. The nature of inquiry is to go, oh, I'm feeling despair about this, or a sense of hopelessness, or I'm feeling angry about this. And it's in the allowing of that that you can discover directly what's free of it. Where is this oasis of peace? Where are you placing your attention? And so the purpose in inquiry is to end your suffering. And suffering happens as we avoid whatever we're really feeling, when we're not willing to tell ourselves the truth about what's really going on inside of us. So really, it's like a ruthless kind of honesty that's required here. So there's kind of this need to be ruthlessly honest with yourself, Jonathan. What deep down is bringing you here? Because there's something that you want. And what is that? And deeper than that, what is that? And then deeper and deeper, what is that? To discover instead of knowing. Because in knowing, there's a kind of deadness. Even if you've had awake moments and sublime experiences of truth, once it's in the past and you keep referencing the past, it's the dead past. It's not fresh anymore. It's not alive anymore. So it's always here now. Aurora happened several days ago, and the news, yes, it keeps filtering out, but it's in the past, and it evoked certain emotions. So what's here now? It's always about that. It's always about what's this fresh look at what's here now for me. So what I'm saying is to actually let your mind fall into the heart. And stop following this movement of mind. So when I stop and say to you, what is it that you really want? What is it that you want, Jonathan? Really want? I mean, this is what you really want, which brings you to these meetings, which brings you to this conversation. What is it deep down that you want? It's a very important question to ask yourself. Right. It's kind of crazy. That's the nature of mind. It's kind of crazy. But the oasis of your heart is nothing but peace. Because I get that you have a very strong intellect. And this is great. This is actually really good news because you can use that intellect to really penetrate deeply inside yourself. So the challenge for you is to stop looking outward at what's going on in your circumstances and really turn the mind inward. And that's why I was saying giving yourself this job of finding the depth of the oasis, the depth of peace within you. I'm not talking about meditation. I'm not talking about anything that comes up in your mind. It's what is aware of the mind, what is aware inside of you of the thoughts, and giving your attention to that awareness. That's the gateway in. But the real gateway for you is to actually meet what you're avoiding. And there's something that you keep popping away from. I don't know what it is, but there's something inside of you that is the gateway to freedom. It's that one place you don't want to go. You don't want to feel it. You don't want it to be there. That's the place. Perfect. Perfect. If you're confused, that is perfect, because then the mind doesn't know what to do. And that's exactly right. So what is under the confusion? Where do you feel the confusion in your body? Is there a central location in your body? Do you feel it in your gut? In your heart? In your gut? So let's let yourself just be totally, completely confused. Allow that feeling just to have you totally. And then direct your attention to whatever that is made of. What is the core of confusion? What is at the core of it? And don't go out into a conversation about it, but go into it. What is inside the confusion? So what are you experiencing now? What are you feeling now? Kind of a relief? Is that what you said? Yes. So when you're willing to actually turn and meet the confusion, then there's a relaxing, there's a release. And then if you go even deeper into that release, there might be something else there waiting for you. So if you go into the feeling like, oh, there's this release, there's this opening, what's inside the opening? Deeper nothing. And so you can give your mind this task of finding an end to the deeper nothing. Because the mind does want a job. It wants something to do. Its purpose, we've talked about the purpose of the mind, is the survival of your physical body. So it has a very distinct purpose. But where suffering comes in is when we give our attention to the endless gyrations of mind, which tends to go to the past or project that past onto the future. So this peace, this freedom, is always here and now when you're willing to stop following that movement of mind outward. Or even inward, because the thoughts can come inward as attack thoughts against yourself. So it's deeper than any thought. And then the challenge over time is to actually start to rest in this realization. So there is a deepening over time, and there's a maturing over time, because this is like, it's like wine. You know, when you first crush grapes, it's just grape juice. But when you bottle it and you set it on the shelf in the perfect temperature, over time, it becomes into some of the greatest wines, are hundreds of years old, or 50, 60 years old, because they've had time to deepen and mature. So there's this awakening to the truth, and then there's this maturing into that realization. Because freedom and lasting happiness is not about the external. It's not about what you're doing. It's not about your circumstances. It's not about changing states, and it's not about your changing emotions. It's what's free of that. And my promise to you is, if you have the resolve to keep returning to this oasis of peace, then your life will transform, I can guarantee, in ways that you cannot even fathom. A life of true, lasting happiness, fulfillment, love, compassion, and true service in whatever you find yourself doing, whatever circumstance you might find yourself in. You are an oasis of peace, of love, of stillness. This is the living truth of who you are. And it's always here and now. Always here, always now. Right. It feels great. Isn't that great news? It feels great. And you can be selfish like Ramana was selfish and give your attention only to that. And you can do that and still function. And in some ways, you're going to be much more clear in your functioning if your attention is on that instead of the crazy movement of the mind. So that's perfect, Jonathan. That's just perfect. That's a great place for you to rest in.